Hey guys, so we're brewing a deck, Colorless Ingest, Blue Red. And so last time we left off, we had built the deck and we're ready to playtest. Except I completely miscounted and it was actually 65 instead of 60. So we gotta cut 5 more cards. So let's go through here and see what we can cut. So I think it's probably going to be like one white herder, just because you don't really want multiples of those that much, just because it's going to be hard to get that many ingest triggers, so we'll get rid of one of those. Need to get rid of 4 more. I think it's going to be... let's see. Let's get rid of probably one bioaggregate. Bioaggregate 3. Just because we're high on the 3 drops. So we're down to 63. We need to take out 3 more. I hate cutting cards, man. Such a pain in the butt. What is not going to be the best? I think Renation Guide's pretty good. Earlier Rogue, I need the artifacts from Thopter Spider. Let's get rid of Processor Assault. I think I still want a few of those, but maybe we can take out one of them. Because again, we don't want too many things to get rid of our exiled cards. And then we need 2 less. So let's go down to... well, let's go down to 2 Hangar Back Walkers and2 Sky Spawners, I think. Should be down to 60. 21, 27, 29, wait. 21, 27, 29, 33, 35, yeah, okay, that's right. Alright, that's better. Now, so, we got our deck together. We will playtest it. See how it goes. Okay, so, the things we want to find out is, you know, does our curve work? And does it synergize well? What do we need to cut? What do we need to keep? So let's see. Let's reflect changes back in here. So we got 2 of those. Cut one of those. Cut one of those. Let's make sure. Do we still have Thopter Stag? Okay, 3. We cut one of those. Cut one of those. And one more thing. No, it wasn't that. Maybe it was a Mr. Trigger. No, it was one of these. Wow, that aggregate. Okay. So let's count up our curve, make sure it's still good. If it's not, we're gonna have to add some stuff back in. So, we've got 4 1 drops, those are the Ghost Fire Blades. 2 drops, we've got 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. No, it should be 6. 6 there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 2 drops. We're gonna play on turn 2. Oh, Alright, turn 3. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Looks like 9. Yeah, 9. 4, 6, 9. 4 drops. We got 5 ones still, or are we down from that? We got 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7. No, wait, don't. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, that's right. 5. And 5 drops, we have cut down on one of them, so we're at 3. We're at 3, 5 drops. Okay, so that's like a pretty good curve. It looks smoothed out. Got plenty of stuff at the low and the high end. One thing you don't want to have is a big spike, which happens a lot with like 3 and 4 drops, or, you know, so. You want to avoid that, but this looks good. Majority is 3 drops, but it's not like much higher than the 2 or 4s. Okay, so we're good on the curve part. The other cards are going to just kind of fit in anywhere. So, okay, we are going to test this out. So remember, we're going to pretend that these are any color lands. So this. And this hand is keepable, I think. It's missing the 2 drops, which is disappointing, but it's not terrible. It's turn 2. I'm not going to play anything turn 2, unfortunately. So we're going to hit that. Okay, so in order to play the Spy Network, we could play the Sky Spawner, and the next turn play Spy Network, but then we're not going to actually hit, we're not going to really do much with that. So maybe we do Herald of Kozilek into the Brutal Expulsion, or we go aggro-y and go Vile Aggregate, and then next turn, if we draw a land, we can hit World Rogue and then attack for, what, 3 or something. That's not great, but this is going to get better over time. I think it's going to be better later. So let's play the Herald. Don't need that. And then next turn, okay, we drew a land. So we can play probably 2 things. We can play this and that, which would be pretty strong. Or we could play just a Spy Network, or we could play Whirler Rogue. I think I'm gonna go with both of these, so play this for 2, we get a guy, and we get this guy for 2. So now he's a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He's a 4, 5 for 3. So he's already pretty good. Next turn. Okay, we got 5 mana now. Our colorless spell still costs 1 less, so we've got, I mean, last turn we have pretty decent blockers. So turn 3 we played him, he's a pretty good blocker. Turn 4 we played both of these guys, and got a Scion, so that's pretty decent too. What we could have also done is played, we could have played him, got the Scion, then sacked it for the expulsion. That would have been decent too, but I think it's better just to get a bunch of guys out. So, we are going to play. I think our Whirler Rogue is pretty good right now. Play that. One thing I do notice is that this is good, but with these cards it kind of clogs it up quite a bit. You know, you're not really like letting your hand go, but it's not bad. So we're going to make 2 tokens from that. So now this guy's going to be a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, a 6, 5, I think it was. Let's see what this guy does now. I think it's a 5. Yeah, it's a 5. So it's a 6, 5 for 3. That's pretty gnarly with Trample and Ingest. So that's going to be quite a bit of damage. And then we got the Flyer. Depends on what they have out, obviously. But it's turn 5. So it's turn 3, turn 4, turn 5, we play these, attack for 6, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6. Yeah. So it's attack for 6 on turn 5. And maybe ingest something, we'll see. And, yeah, so that's pretty good. That seems like a decent play. Alright, so now we got the Ruination Guide. We also have the option of playing Spy Network and just getting tokens over time, which is kind of cool. You can maybe hit them with a few tokens and draw some cards. Maybe draw a land. Or draw one card, actually. Only draw one card. Or we could play this and this because the Kozilek. So we could play, I think we probably would want to do that. So we'd play Ruination Guide, give everything +1/+0. And then Explosion, you know, return a creature, kill a thing, ingest, or whatever, exile something so we can ingest later. That's going to use up all our lands. And then, so now we've got 2-1 flyers, 2-1 flyers. This guy's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 from this. He's going to be an 8, 5 for 3. I mean, he gets pretty nuts after a while, I think. Unless they kill him, he's probably pretty powerful. I mean, he beats the Seed right now, which is good. We got, and then all our guys are going to be pumped. So that makes these quite a bit better. He's 3-1, yeah. Seems pretty fast. Maybe some more tempo cards would be better. But we got the Assault, which is good, because we just ingested some stuff. The Expulsion, so, you know, Assault would be pretty good. Maybe we can hit them. Well, actually, let's do this. We could play a Top Tier Spy Network, hit them, and maybe draw a card and hit a land, maybe? Ah, no land. But, oh, actually, these cost one less. I forgot about that. So that costs one less. Or this also costs one less. So they both cost one, which is pretty crazy. A one mana counterspell is something that they're really not going to see coming. I think this card might be better than I originally thought it would be. So maybe we want to put in a few more of these. This is why you playtest, so you can tell which things are good. So, yeah, I like him. What could we change out? So maybe we take out a Mist Intruder in favor of Herald. But we're already pretty good mix right now. And I like all our three drops. You know, Whirler Rogue. You know, Thopter Spy Network seems pretty clunky in this deck, but we do need the card advantage. Maybe there's other options for card advantage that might not be bad. Let's look them up. Let's see what we can find here. Because, you know, Spy Network is good. But in this deck, it doesn't necessarily trigger all the time. So it's, you know, it's a little inconsistent. It is powerful, because it's going to make your guy, or get a bunch of 1-1s. Maybe it's a better sideboard or something. I don't know. So let's see. We got to find some draw stuff. So let's, do standard and draw. Might come up with too many results. Let's do red, blue, or colorless. And no other colors. Okay. So far, it seems wrong. It's just one game. Seems pretty good. Draw. Oh, this one's a good draw card. We want a draw engine, really. This is what we're looking for. That's one thing where Fathom Feeder might come in, but it does cost 5. It does fuel ingest though, in exile, that's decent. Actual card advantage though. Military intelligence. Oh, dang. Stupid M15. That'd be so rude. Monastery Siege, I like. But it doesn't actually give you card advantage, it's just filtering. Let's see here. Where is the draw spells? Need some stuff that draws cards. Summer of the Great Hunt. That's not necessarily the worst. It's kind of weird. But it might be strong. We have lots of fires. If fires, they're gonna get bigger. And get some card advantage off of it. We do have some things that are gonna get pretty big from the power forward greater. You know, this is something that you wouldn't think is gonna be good, but it could be. That guy's probably gonna be forward greater. Anything with a ghost fire blade is probably gonna be forward greater. Plus once they hit, they get a counter. I like that it's powerful and aggressive. It's not gonna pump anything though. Like, it's not going to get pumped by that or pump this. And it can't be equipped by Ghostfire Blade easily. But it might be worth it just because. I don't know. Let's see. So it'd be a direct replacement for Falter Spy Network. I don't know. It's less clunky, but it's not gonna. It's gonna get you a lot of cards, though. I don't know. I'm not sure. It's aggressive. It might be a little bit too aggressive. Maybe calling them over. Maybe. He seems decent in this. Well, let's keep going. Keep looking. Okay, so we got Smothering Abomination is black. Can't do that guy. Actually isn't card advantage, it's just filtering. Treasure Cruise, probably not going to be able to do. Vision of Insight, I don't think is worth it in this deck. Well, let's see, it's all the draw stuff. Also stuff that just draws us cards. I kind of like that one. It's aggressive. It's going to draw us cards. Pretty good amount of cards. And this ability is very powerful, probably, for a lot of our things. We're going to have lots of flying creatures, trample is just gonna hit them probably, flying creatures, Ghostfire Blade's gonna pump, so it's gonna do that.
Yeah.
I like him. Sure. Why not? Let's put in a couple of those and see what happens. Times two and times three. It's a little clunky. Okay, let's go back. Here's the thing that goes back to the... Oh, no, top of the red. Okay, edit. I'm going to get rid of Flappish Network and put in... My name is... Sean the Great Hunt. You really don't know how good cards are until you try them out. So, let's see. Good. Okay, deck test. Alright, so we got turn one, Ghostfire Blade. Ghostfire Blade. Next turn. Oh, yeah, see, this is good. Mist Intruder. That's gonna happen every once in a while. Probably shouldn't do anything about it. Hit him for three. It's not bad. Turn three. If we had another land, we could play the processor assault and kill the guys. Yeah. Okay. So probably should mulligan two and things. Let's restart. Here's another two land hand. Okay. We do have this, so if we hit our third land, it's gonna be better. Go with it. Hey, there it is. Third land. Hit him for one. Exile card. And we got... Okay, so we got this thing we could play after we hit him. That seems pretty good. Or we could play a Sky Spawner and a Aggregate. Or we could play a Word of a Rogue. I think we just want to hit him and then blight her. We get three. I think. Pretty sure it's three. Let's see, it's three. Yeah, we get three. Okay. Okay, so that was pretty good. Ghostfire Blade's pretty awesome right now. Costs zero, so might as well play it. And let's see, we also have the three mana over here, but maybe it's not best. That'll cost two. This guy will also cost two, and then get another Scion, and then maybe we sack it and equip the Ghostfire Blade or something. Let's see. But right now, this guy is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. He is a 9-5. No, this guy's a 9-5. That is pretty gnarly. It's only creatures, right? Yeah. So Ghostfire Blade doesn't count. I wish it did. And then next turn, it's gonna be another Ghostfire Blade for free. we're rogue, maybe? I don't know. Maybe we just wanna equip this thing twice or something. Maybe we can even just do it on the fly or something. No. But 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, plus 2, plus 2. 13, a 13-5 with trample and ingest. That is pretty nutter butter right there. By turn 6, 2. I'm pretty sure by turn 6, because turn 4 we played this. Turn 5 we played that. And something else. Ghost Starblade. Something else. I don't remember. Oh yeah, this guy and this guy. Yeah. And then turn 6, we get to attack for 13. And a bunch of other things. So it seems pretty good. You know, it all depends on what they do, obviously, but it seems strong. I'm not a huge fan of Whirler Rogue now, that it's not, like, it's not colorless, so it only makes, you know, the only thing I like about Whirler Rogue is you can tap the artifacts, so if I were, I could just play him and tap artifacts and then he'd be unblockable, which would be pretty insane. I mean, that's pretty mean, but maybe, instead of doing that, maybe we just play a Rogue's Passage, the land, and, play some more, like, Herald of Kozilex or something, just so we can get this explosiveness, you know, reliably. Because playing these at one mana is very good. So maybe we want to get rid of the Whirler Rogues. Or maybe just a few of them. And yeah, Whirler Rogue can be taken out for maybe a few more of these Sky Spawners. Maybe a few more of the Sky Spawners. And a few more of the Heralds of Kozilex. Those are actually turning out to be really good. So let's do that. Let's take out the Whirler Rogues. Put those out. Let's go with Herald of Kozilex. Let's go a couple more of those. Maybe four. Maybe just three of them. Let's go 3 and then 4 Sky Spawners. Or no. No, let's go 3 of those and then one more. Where's that guy? Where's the big dude? I like Ruination guy. Let's do another one of those. Maybe not even a Sky Spawner. Let's just take out that and put in the Vowel Aggregate. Oh, what the fire's there. No, yeah, let's keep doing this Sky Spawners. Okay, how many flyers do we have? We have this and this. We got 5. Oh, wait, no. Missed intruders. Yeah, I forgot about this. So we still got plenty of flyers. We should be good. Okay. So let's do a few more times just to, you know, get the actual, normal thing going here. Mist Intruder, that's pretty sweet. Hit him with Mist Intruder, Processor Assault him, it's pretty decent. On turn 3. Turn 4, we can Brutal Explosion them, or we could do both of these. I think we're probably just gonna Brutal Explosion them. Hit them for another 1. So we're gonna get a thing out for that. Yeah, that's pretty good. Ghostfire Blade, flip him. It's gonna get to be a 3-4? 3-4? Yeah, 3-4. And then we get to keep up, maybe even just use a Processor Assault and get rid of their guy. Turn 5, we already played, 3 removal spells. I mean, that's pretty strong. We get rid of, like, a lot of stuff. And counter spell probably, or return something. That's pretty good. Only question is, did they kill this? You know, it's questionable, but I don't know. Depends on what deck you're playing. So right now we're kind of mana flooded. We got 6 lands. Not the best, but hit him for another 3. Maybe play a Reality Shift. So this is where the card advantage comes in. You really want You really want some stuff that's gonna keep you still playing even after, you know, a start like this where you blow your whole hand and then you just don't have anything. So, yeah, I mean, there's nothing you can do about it when you just keep drawing lands. Let's just start. But it still seemed like there was a chance. Okay, so Ghost Fireblade. Can't play that yet. Alright, Ruination Guide or Valakriate. I think this guy is better right now. Do that. We got the guide. We get the pump. Get to hit him for 1, 2, 3, 3, 3 plus 2, 5. So 5, 7. Pretty strong on turn 4. 5, 7. And we just adjusted the card so we can do this now. We can equip another Ghost Fireblade, maybe this guy. I don't know. Hit him with a Processor Assault. Whatever they played, maybe they played a Seed Rhino. I don't know. Hit him for 5, 10. That's pretty good. We are still a little bit mana flooded because we're coming. Yeah, we're drawing so many lands. It's kind of, that's a lot of land. Turn 6. That's 13 cards drawn, and out of 7 we have, or out of 13 we have 7, which is not normal. That's pretty mana flooded. But what could happen is we could cut one more land because we do have the
we have the Kozilex,
the whatever they are, the Herald of Kozilek that makes your stuff cheaper. So it could be that we just don't need that many lands. We'll do one more and see. Let's start. Okay, so we got to land. We're getting flooded again. Okay. Two of those Ghost Fireblades. We got an Eldrazi processor. Or a, whatever the guy is, Sky something. And we're just drawing more lands again. Yeah, I think we do. We do. I mean, despite that, we still have some pretty good power on board on turn 4, but. Jeez. Let's take it all in, so we can do that. The question is, what are we going to put in instead? Other land. 24 lands. And let's go with, I think another Shaman of the... Although, let's put in... Let's see. We still don't have too many artifacts. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And that's it now. So, I still don't think the Thopter network, Spy network, is going to be great. I think maybe just not a great hunt. Try that. Save. Still haven't dropped that. Okay, that's a Morgan. Obviously. Alright, so we got 1, next turn. 2, we play Mirror Back Walker for 2. Play a Herald, Kozilek. Seems good. And then we play a. On turn 4, we play both of these guys, Ruination Guide and the. File aggregate. That's pretty sweet. This guy's still at 1. Okay, now we can Brutal Expulsion. So this guy's 1, 2, 3, 4. It's a 4, 5. Not super strong right now. But once we start getting Fingerback Walker, you know. So we can Brutal Expulsion them. Pump Hangerback Walker up 1, and then next turn Shaman of the Great Hunt. Maybe we keep Hangerback Walker open again. I mean, we have some pretty good synergy going on here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The attack is going to get bigger. Next turn, Shaman of the Great Hunt. Probably draw some cards with it. That'd be pretty cool. Let's see, so we got 1, 2, 3, 4. Anything else that's bigger? I've got some other creatures, so that doesn't work. Oh, it's actually 5. It's 5 because of the creation guy. We got 3. Maybe we can, like, pump. So we could pump Hangerback Walker to 4. And then draw 3 cards from that. 1, 2, 3. Play land. Draw more of these. I guess those aren't the bad. Those aren't the worst in multiples. Because you can still hit them and get more counters on them. Yeah, I mean, this seems good. I think this is about where I'm going to leave off and just say, you know, if you want to build this deck, go ahead. That seems pretty good, despite having not too many cards that are worth anything besides Hangerback Walker. 2 of them, I think. You can always, you know, substitute those for something else. But yeah, it seems pretty sweet. So I think I'm gonna brew the other versions of the deck, just so you can see kind of how I do the branching and like building the other versions. And then you can kind of see like which one's better, so I'll do that. But for right now, here's the list. Let's see here. And here is the URL. I'll post that in the comment section or the whatever it is, description. And yeah, here's the list, and so you can make that. Obviously the lands still need to be worked out, but it is only two colors, so it shouldn't be too hard. You could also put in the lands that, like for instance, the, like what I was talking about with the unblockable one. The thing that gives unblockable, I don't remember what it's called now. Rogue's Passage? Yeah, Rogue's Passage. So that'll be really good with the, with a lot of this stuff, especially the whatever it's called, Vile Aggregate. That'll be pretty good. So whatever, you can do whatever you want with this. Alright, thanks for watching, and I will make the next video.